56 years and above. And then for the
itself, how the spaces that I come up with scientific and detail about their own own activities that come up with the impact of therapeutic. So I have supported the concept with the theme restorative landscape, which is the restorative setting, because I have maintained the orchard environment itself and also the nature setting, so that the therapeutic impact will, you know, easily delivered to the inmates. Okay, as for the spaces, as for the master plan, I have divided into main spaces. At this area is actually for the future development. They want to propose a resort, a chalet for for the night walk at the orchard itself. So this is the entrance for the visitors only, and this is the entrance for the inmates. They have moved from their dorm, so their view will towards the garden and to be the entrance. So this is for the visitors. Visitors will actually just see this chalet first. The chalet, I'm giving the cathartic chalet. So this is the lobby, this is the chalet area. So I divided into two kinds of chalet, the long one and also the single one, so that the dome one, I want to give the sense of like the inmates' dorms. Inmates that don't live in cell, they have their own dorm. So this dorm will kind of related to the prison itself, but doesn't be like in prison.
What is the access to the chalet?
Access?
To the
chalet. To the chalet. It's the administration parking. From
here. The parking,
Public.
The bicycle track is just only for the tourists and for the tourists itself.
to feel the life environment of this place. Okay. Next, I proceed to the enlargement plan. Okay, my enlargement plan. This is the Bagansina, and this is the Kebun Krang. This is the space for the Titi Bagan. The Titi Bagan is functional as the infinity of Titi Bagan. At this place, we are bridging the community to get more closer to each other while appreciating of the natural values at this Titi Bagan. Okay. These are the supporting drawing for my Titi Bagan. Okay, this Titi Bagan is Titi Bagan have its gazebo and its Titi. The function of its gazebo is for the community to sell their fresh market. For example, the Chinese community want to sell the vegetable from the Kebun Hydro. Okay, daripada Kebun Hydro, dia akan community Cina akan menghasilkan sayur-sayuran dan akan dijual di sini. Manakala orang Melayu akan menternak lembu, dan daging-daging lembu dan kambing itu akan dijual di sini, di mana Chinese dan Melayu akan bertukar-tukar makanan tersebut untuk diorang punya sustain daripada village diorang, dengan saya menggunakan balik sistem barter. Which means that sekiranya 1 kg sayur akan mendapat 500 gram daging. So dia akan meningkatkan ekonomi kawasan komuniti tersebut, serta mengurangkan masalah homeless di kawasan-kawasan sekitar. Okay, kemudian next, this is my section from the parking area to the Kebun Terang area, which is the public space, and the two is the fashion towards the mangrove area. As we can see, the clock tower has to present the landmark of this place, and the visual view from the outside, as they can see the clock tower as it is the Kebun Terang area. So these are the Kebun Terang area. The Kebun Terang area has the exercise bagan jetty, which means an excellent attraction, which can give some beautiful and delicious memories for tourists who come here. As we can see, the jetty Kampung Bagan is the functional to the tourists to go to the Pulau Angsa and Sky Mirror. Perbezaan Sky Mirror dekat Kuala Selangor dengan dekat sini adalah dekat sini segini air surut, dia ada alur yang boleh pergi ke sini dengan mudah daripada jetty di Kuala Selangor. So sebab orang tak tahu, sebab tu benda tu tak dipopularkan. Okay, next. Sekini, after upgrading this area, so it will automatically increase the income of the community itself. So the money from the jetty Kampung Bagan, the pasar borong Kampung Bagan, and the Titi Bagan itself, all those programs will give back to the community itself. Okay, these are the sections of the Rumah Jenahah. Rumah Jenahah is one of the homestay that are provided to the tourists, or maybe for the backpackers or for the family itself. Okay, if the tourists want to stay at this Kampung Bagan Sungai Buloh, we provided a lot of homestay, which I provided 4 types of homestay. The first one is Rumah Baung, Rumah Arwana, and Rumah Gelama, and the one is Ratak Bagan. These 4 types of homestay has a different type of design and has its own specialized. Okay.
Yang nama-nama rumah tu bagi ke atau
rumah? Rumah tu saya bagi. Right. This is my pavilion. They have proposed more fruit trees that I want to attract the society, that the neighborhood come to the nature and to get more activities, more society activities.
Alright.
And the last one is the population and the project design program that gives socio-economic stability of the school community participation and sustainability.
Thank you.
air naik semua kan. Lepas tu ada kemungkinan adalah jangka terlepas tu. Itu mungkin boleh possibility je lah. Dari segi aspek safety lah.
Tapi dekat sini
pun
ada
tangga
dan jenis tinggi. Lepas tu yang ni yang
tinggi
lah. Banyak air tu
takkan saya melihat kepada sungai Sarawak, sungai Sarawak tu nak. Dia hanya buat boat untuk tua je. Kalau berkayak ni mungkin tak pernah tengok lah.
Macam okay, design tu okay. Design tu okay kan. Facility okay. Cuma aktiviti tu mungkin tak sesuai. Okay, maksudnya you design ni dah space dah dibukakan yang you yang dibukakan yang aku design fine. And then tapi bila aktiviti kayak tu